All right, boys, it is a new season and a new expansion, so you know what's up. We have a bunch of new weapons, exotics, new armors. We're going to be going through everything today. Timestamps will be down below. Feel free to click to whichever one you want, but let's get started. First up, no time to explain. This is an exotic kinetic pulse rifle. Shoots at 340 rounds per minute. That's right, our high impact archetype. Comes with the exotic perk Rewind Again. Precision shots and shots against combatants slowed or frozen by stasis will return to the magazine. Really interesting that this weapon actually ties into stasis so much. Also comes with the legendary trait, Time Slip. At 10 stacks of Rewind Again, a small portal will open, shooting bullets from an alternate timeline version of this weapon. Precision hits extends the portal's duration. Now, it also comes with an exotic catalyst called Blast from the Side, allowing projectiles from the time portal to shoot more frequently. So even more rapid fire, and yes, it was confirmed by somebody at Bungie, and I don't know if it's actually the case or not because we haven't tested it, but supposedly we can stack that little walk-around portal on No Time to Explain with Getaway Artists and Arc Buddies. Sounds nasty. Moving on to our next weapon. This is actually on the Season Pass. This is a slug or a hybrid shotgun that converts to a slug present in our energy slot duality. It states fires a pellet spread in hip fire or a single high damage slug when aiming down sights. Very interesting that the shotgun is essentially the best of both worlds. There are times where somebody's rushing you and you want to just get a shot off. It's still a regular shotgun from the hip, but converts into a slug when aiming down sights. Now, it comes with the legendary trait, Black Wings. Pellet final blows grant stacking precision damage and a reload speed buff. Precision hits with the slug extends the duration. Hopefully, we're gonna have a review for this weapon pretty soon. It does also have an exotic catalyst, which increases the range by plus 20. A very healthy looking shotgun. Probably gonna be a major competitor to Chaperone. Moving on to our sniper rifle, Cloud Strike. This is an exotic energy sniper rifle. Shoots at 140 rounds per minute. So essentially a rapid fire sniper. Comes with the perk, Mortal Polarity. Precision final blows generate a lightning bolt at a target's location. We've seen this in action, extremely deadly. However, it does require a precision shot or final blow to actually proc that lightning bolt. Now it comes with the trait, Stormbringer. Rapid precision hits will create a lightning storm at the point of impact. So even before you land the final blow, rapidly landing damage on a target if the precision shots will spawn this lightning storm. Potentially, Cloud Strike could be a DPS option for rapid fire snipers. It does have an exotic catalyst, but it's got a block on it, so we can't even see what it does. Moving on, Salvation's Grip. This is an exotic power grenade launcher. Shoots at 120 rounds per minute, and it deals stasis damage. Comes with the exotic perk, Cryo Cannon. Hold to charge, release to fire. This weapon's projectiles create stasis crystals and freezes nearby targets. It also comes with the legendary trait, Flash Freeze. Charging this weapon increases the freeze radius and the amount of stasis crystals created. It too also comes with an exotic catalyst though that's being blocked out, and I don't know if that means we do have a catalyst for it or if like a future expansion will bring that about. Regardless though, epic looking grenade launcher. Love that it also deals stasis damage. Gonna be really interesting. Moving on to Eyes of Tomorrow. This is an exotic power rocket launcher. People are actually calling this thing Galahorn 2.0. We'll see. Shoots at 20 rounds per minute, putting it in that adaptive archetype, things like Apex Predator, Bellowing Giant. This weapon comes with the exotic perk, Eyes on All. The weapon is capable of tracking and firing at multiple targets simultaneously. The hell is that? What? It also comes with the trait, Adaptive Ordnance. Killing four more combatants in a single volley increases the damage of the next volley. Yeah, I don't know, guys. This sounds like Galahorn 2.0. That thing does look mean, though, man. Holy hell. Moving on to our sword, the Lament. We've seen a lot of gameplay of this one. This is an exotic power sword. Comes with the exotic perk, Banshee's Wail. Hold fire to rev the blade. Increases damage. Also bypasses shields and has a shield-piercing attack. You also gain stacks when dealing damage with revved attacks. Additional stacks increase the damage and damage resistance of heavy attacks. Now, the traits on the weapon are Jagged Edge, which is great for increasing our impact. Enduring Guard. Tireless Blade, which allows us to grant ourselves more ammo for every other powered sword kill, and it comes with the legendary trait, Revved Consumption. Damaging combatants actually heal the wielder. We were questioning if this sword was actually going to be good in in-game content, because you got to close the gap. You got to be so close to everything. This is how they're going to fix it. You can literally heal yourself by not even getting a kill, but simply damaging combatants. Now, the question is, How much can you heal yourself? I don't know. We'll just have to try it out. Now, moving on to our other exotics on this list. Before we get into the legendary weapons, we have Precious Scars. This is a Titan exotic helmet. We went over this when Bungie actually debuted their Beyond Light exotics. Comes with the exotic intrinsic perk, Kintsugi. Am I saying that right? Kintsugi? After reviving or being revived, you gain an aura that provides overshields to you and nearby allies. Interesting. This may be a great exotic on day one raids, especially with contest mode. The question is how much does that aura actually provide in terms of overshields to your teammates, but looks good. Moving on to Icefall Mantle. This is an exotic Titan gauntlet. Comes with the exotic perk Glacial Guard. Replaces your barricade ability with a personal armor reinforcement that absorbs a small amount of damage. While reinforced, you're slowed and barricade does not recharge. So a lot of people were wondering if Icefall Mantle was going to be too broken. I don't know. I don't think so. You can get another barricade back while you're reinforced and you move slower. So yeah, it does state it only blocks a small amount of damage. So we'll just have to see. Moving on to Mask of Bracchus. Bracchus. Comes with the exotic perk Life Shift. Replaces your stasis subclass dodge ability with a longer range, faster moving shift that partially cloaks you during use. After shifting, your arc weapons deal increased damage for a short time. Interesting. Your arc weapons deal increased damage. What? Really? Okay. Gonna see what weapons we can pair with that. Moving on to Aether's Embrace. Probably killing these names right now. Comes with the exotic perk Skittering Stinger. Weighted knife gains a second bounce. Rapid precision hits with your weapon grant weighted knife a significant damage bonus and the ability to stagger unshielded combatants for a short time. Kind of a specific use here, although for my gunslingers, this does sound pretty nice. Depending on how much that damage boost is gonna be, it's gonna be the deciding choice for me, especially in PvE. Moving on, Don Chorus. This is an exotic warlock helmet. Comes with the perk Rites of Ember. Your daybreak projectiles causes targets to burn on contact and deal more damage to them. All your burn effects last longer, and you also gain a small amount of melee energy each time one of your burns damages a target. Now, the question is for this one, for me, does the damage over time apply? Like, keep reapplying that melee energy buff, decreasing that cooldown. It's interesting that the debuff there states that the daybreak projectile causes targets to burn on contact and you deal more damage to them. Does this apply to other weapons or just the daybreak damage? Again, Don Chorus, ugly looking exotic, but it deserves a lot of testing. Moving on to Necrotic Grip, comes with the exotic perk Grasp of the Devourer. Damaging combatants with melee attacks corrupts them with increasing damage over time. Defeating a corrupted combatant spreads the corrupt effect to nearby targets and restores melee energy. This is a really interesting exotic. We've seen some gameplay of it. It will consistently keep procking that poison damage over and over again with each kill that it gets. Almost having an infinite loop there in its damage as long as it's getting kills. Could be extremely disgusting when it comes to ad control. All right, those are our exotics for Beyond Light. And again, the only ones we can see. Obviously, there's probably going to be a few more quest-related ones, Hawkmoon, etc. But those are not present in the database. Let's move on to legendary weapons. Starting from the top, we have Biting Winds. This is a legendary kinetic combat bow, 684 draw time. But for any of my guys that are Sutta Calamity fans, bam, got that Europa Destination look to it. So it's definitely a destination related weapon. Got a number of different traits here. Let's talk about some of the new ones. First up, Surplus. Increased handling, reload speed, and stability for each fully charged ability. Wow. So your melee, your grenade, and maybe your super will all contribute to bonuses toward these three stats. Very interesting. As far as the best things to get on this one, I always like explosive head pretty good. Swashbuckler, rapid hit. Surplus might be an option that I'm going to go for just to try it, just to see. Depending on how big of a reload speed bump we get, as well as handling and other things, it may be the way to go. Moving on to a hand cannon that is going to probably be dropping an Iron Banner, as it is an Iron Banner weapon, the Steady Hand. Used to be a 110 round per minute hand cannon. Now it is a 120. And with it are actually going to be the two perks that came last season, Iron Grip and Iron Gaze. One greatly boosting stability at the cost of reload speed, while the other one greatly boosting aim assist at the cost of range. I would not recommend that. Minus 40 range is a tough one. It also has a new trait found on the weapon called Wellspring. Kills with this weapon generate ability energy. This energy is divided between your uncharged abilities. So essentially, think Demolitionist, but for everything. It will be divided between uncharged abilities, but I'm assuming if you have like one ability that's on cooldown and the other ones are full, everything's going to go into that one ability. If that perk is actually potent enough, I probably would utilize that for something like PvE. For my PvP guys, though, I want you to try Killing Wind Snapshot. And if not that, Killing Wind Swashbuckler. I don't think Iron Grip or Iron Gaze is necessary. Moving on, we have Hell in Confusion. This is a kinetic pulse rifle shooting at 390 rounds per minute. Think Bygones. Has some decent traits. Perk-wise, it too comes with the two new perks, Surplus as well as Wellspring. Now, a perk to not overlook is Elemental Capacitor. And as far as I know, Elemental Capacitor gives you increase in stat bonuses based on the subclass you have equipped, Solar, Arc, and Void. I don't see anything in a database stating anything about stasis and whether or not there's actually a stat bump in any kind of way related to stasis. However, I will say the stability bump when rocking a Void subclass and Elemental Capacitor is extremely nice. We are not in a pulse rifle meta though, but to prepare for that, I would suggest Elemental Capacitor and Firmly Planted. For PvE players, you can't go wrong with Demolitionist and maybe Wellspring over Demolitionist, depending on the differences between ability regeneration. Moving on, we have the Guiding Sight. This is actually a kinetic scout rifle for Iron Banner, a 150 round per minute scout, which we know does have an acquisition buff. Pretty much all scouts got an acquisition buff. It's got a couple of new traits though. First up, does have the Iron Grip, Iron Gaze present on this weapon if you wanted to boost the aim assist and be nutty about it. Comes with Vorpal as well, which is extremely nice. Surplus for that trait in that first column, which increased handling on a 150, depending on how much it actually maxes those things out. This might be a better option over Quick Draw. But the new trait, One for All, which is in that final column, hitting three separate targets increases damage for a moderate duration. Interesting. I don't know. I don't know if that's a good trait or not. One, I don't know what a moderate duration actually is in Bungie's eyes. And two, what's the damage buff? It may exceed that of Vorpal for PvE. And this is something that you can apply damage buff to not just major targets, but any target. As long as you hit three separate targets. That is very specific though. PvP, you might have to work to get that to work. Now moving on. By the way, I just want to mention we are skipping Adept Weapon. Adept weapons do not seem to be any different in terms of roles from our current versions. And we really won't know how much different Adept weapons are until this Friday when they're actually dropping in our hands and we see how the new Adept weapons are going to be structured. So not covering Adept weapons in this video, but next up on the list is a kinetic sidearm called High Albedo. This is an adaptive sidearm shooting at 491 rounds per minute. And as you can see, has a number of new traits, Wellspring, Surplus, all that good stuff. Not exactly in a sidearm meta, but I do like them in PvE. It is present in the kinetic slot, which is interesting. And it comes with Demolitionist. I think I would be inclined to try this out with Wellspring and perhaps Surplus. Moving on to Friction Fire. This is a kinetic submachine gun present in that precision frame archetype, meaning it shoots at 600 rounds per minute. Does not come with scopes. Just mentioning that right up front. I know. I've been waiting on another SMG that actually comes with scopes. That's a 600. Does have barrel perks though. Does come with the new traits. Most notably, Killing Wind. I like that. Killing Wind in combination with perhaps Slideways. That could be an interesting PvP combo. If not that, maybe just Zim Moment and whatever damage dealing perk we got here. Rampage. Yeah. Try that. For PvE, I would suggest Subsistence, Rampage. You can't go wrong with that. And make sure you stack it out with a magazine boosting perk. Moving on, we have Arctic Haze. Arctic Haze is a legendary energy auto rifle. Shoots at 720 rounds per minute. We don't have many 720s. This weapon comes actually with a completely new trait called Thresh. Killing combatants with this weapon generates a small amount of super energy. Wow. Alrighty then. Stack that up with Subsistence. Yeah, that would probably be the role I would go for PvE. Maybe not necessarily PvP. For PvP though, Elemental Capacitor, Killing Wind, you definitely want to give that one a go. But hands down, that Thresh trait is the most interesting trait. So I would probably choose that over everything else. Moving on, Corollius Force. This weapon is a 660 charge time fusion rifle. When's the last time you got hyped for a fusion? Well, maybe this one. Comes with a new trait, One for All, as well as Thresh. One for All might be a little more difficult here. Hitting three separate targets to get that increase in damage. Fusion rifles do shoot off a volley of fusion shots, so you might be able to get the spread out to hit multiple enemies to proc One for All. So maybe those are the two big traits I'm going to be looking at to test on this weapon. Outside of that, it does come with things like Killing Wind, Rangefinder together, which might be a nasty combo to try out on a 660. Next up, we have Deafening Whisper. This is an energy grenade grenade launcher, shoots at 72 rounds per minute. And if you notice, it's another wave frame grenade launcher. We only have one of these, which is Marnie. Deafening Whisper will now join the clan of wave frames. These are these grenade launchers that literally shoot off a wave of damage. And in this case, it will be a void wave. Now the curator role actually looks pretty good. Does come with proximity grenades, although not necessary, as this is one of those weapons you just shoot the ground with. Perks to look for on this weapon though. I think Ambitious Assassin is really good. Combined with Rampage is very interesting. Do a wave of damage, proc two shots. That would be the PvE combo I would go for. Outside of that, I'm curious to know how Killing Wind affects this weapon. Increases weapon range, so maybe you can just shoot the weapon further or shoot the projectile further. I don't know. We'll see. Stars in Shadow. This is a legendary energy pulse rifle. Shoots at 340 rounds per minute. Wow, a lot of high impact pulses here. This weapon does deal solar damage, and it has so many traits. I almost want to think this is bugged out, but maybe it really does have this many options. But this could be a nasty option for PvP for those consistent two taps. First up, firmly planted, moving target. You can't go wrong with it. Or firmly planted elemental capacitor. Don't overlook this pulse rifle for PvP. I know I said we're not in a pulse rifle meta. This one might change our minds. It even has other perks though. Feeding Frenzy, Kill Clip. You've got the new traits on it. Thresh, Surplus. For PvE, I like Disruption Break always. You also got Feeding Frenzy and Outlaw. This looks like a very solid pulse rifle. Moving on, Royal Chase. This is an energy scout rifle. Shoots at 180 rounds per minute. 180s are not in a strong spot. Even with the acquisition buff, we still might give it a chance though. Does come with perks like full auto, which I don't necessarily need on a 180, but you can definitely rely on it if you want. Combine that with say something like Dragonfly. I like the idea of auto loading holster and perhaps Dragonfly together. There is that breast trait. Who knows? That may be the play here. We just got to test that trait out individually. Moving on, we have Bone Chiller. This is a legendary energy shotgun. Shoots at 65 rounds per minute. Present in that precision frame. This weapon actually has a completely new trait we haven't seen yet, called Dual Loader. Reloads two shells at a time, but at the reduction of reload speed. Actually gives us a minus 50 there in reload speed. I don't know if it's worth it. Maybe. Reload speed is already at 48. Perhaps though, slide ways will be the workaround. Maybe when we slide, we actually load two rounds up instead of one. Huh? Could be the play, guys. Really, really. Outside of that, firmly planted for my people that like to slide. You can even combine it with something like slide ways or opening shot. Opening shot, still such a great trait for shotguns inside of PvP. Hands down, would say you go that route. But again, for PvE, I want to try dual loader with slideways. It's intriguing. Moving on, we have Xeno class. Xeno is another energy shotgun, shoots 80 rounds per minute, present in that lightweight frame. And boy, does it have a lot of traits to choose from. Everything from 1-2 punch, trench barrel, grave robber, even has that dual loader perk. You got swashbuckler down there. A disruption break trait. Again, I hope this is not bugged. We have disruption break on a shotgun. What the hell is happening right now? There's a lot of options, but I'm just going to say right off the bat, this shotgun is going to have to take a lot of testing. Curator roll also comes with clown cartridge. Yeah, this is an oddball shotty. I don't know how it's going to play out, but I absolutely love lightweight shotguns, and I need something to replace Emperor's Courtesy. Moving on, we have Adort. This is the pursuit weapon. You can actually begin this quest today. Pretty sure you pick it up from Banshee. A lot of us were wondering, will this sniper rifle actually replace Beloved for us? Does have a zoom of 45. We'll see how much that has actually changed when we actually try it out. Comes with accurized rounds, triple tap, or vorpal, so actually looks pretty good for PvE. Simultaneously comes with killing wind and snapshot. I have no idea how that's going to play out. This seems like a very far-reaching sniper rifle, especially once you get a kill going and proc killing wind. Again, extending that range increases that bullet magnetism. Adored might be the top-tier option choice for PvP players. We'll see though. Moving on to Blast Batu. Am I saying that right? Batu? Is it 120 rounds per minute grenade launcher? Comes with all kinds of crazy stuff, even a new trait called chain reaction. Each final blow with this weapon creates an elemental damage explosion. Now, what elemental explosion? Is it cycle? That could be interesting. This could be the best grenade launcher when it comes to clearing ads. Hands down, that's the perk I'm looking at the most. You do have other perks that can help it, things like clown cartridge, pulse monitor. I don't know if this is necessarily going to be a DPS option of a weapon, but it is interesting with that trait chain reaction. Could be fantastic for ad clearing. Which takes us to Crowd Pleaser. This is a legendary power grenade launcher. Also shoots at 120 rounds per minute. Comes with things like Thresh, chain reaction, action, fill prep, surplus, do pretty much everything. This one has all kinds of traits. I don't even know which one to go with. Chain reaction, I just keep gravitating toward it. I want to know how good is it. Maybe combine it with clown, huh? Or ambitious assassin? Oh, or maybe just fill prep. We don't have to get too crazy. Fill prep is pretty good here. Next up, we have Corsair's Wrath. This is a linear fusion rifle, which we don't have many of. This one also comes with the new perks, but look at that. Firmly Planted is present on this linear fusion. Linear fusions already have pretty damn good target acquisition. But for my folks that want to use it inside of PvP, hey, Firmly Planted, you can't go wrong with it. Outside of that, though, it does come with Kill Clip Outlaw, which is probably what I'm going to want for PvE. Next on the list, we have Thermal Erosion. This is a machine gun. We've seen some gameplay of this one. Big Chungus for sure. Shoots at 900 rounds per minute, which is a little too fast for my taste, but maybe. Maybe this one will change my mind. Does come with Killing Wind, Dynamic Sway, which is always a great option. Tap the Trigger is definitely a perk to not overlook for PvP. Maybe you want to pair it with something like Quick Draw or Zim Moment. For PvE, though, for me, it's going to be a toss-up between Wellspring and Demolitionist. I just don't know. I don't know which one of these are going to be the better traits. It does come with Dragonfly, which could be an option there. Pace your shots. You have a ton of ammo. So yeah, you could definitely take advantage of something like Dragonfly and Field Prep together. And to our final weapon, we have Sub-Zero Salvo. This is a legendary power rocket launcher, and it has some mean perks as well, including Chain Reaction. I want this trait so bad. Okay, what's happening here? We got Chain Reaction, Ambitious Assassin, Impact Casing. Oh my God, that's what I want. That's exactly the perk I want on this thing. So guys, those are your weapons outside of Adept Weapons. We will go over Adept Weapons individually when they drop this Friday. Let me know in the comments below what you think though. Fellas and ladies, thank you all for coming and watching. And as always,
slap that like button like your mama told you right.